I have to say that whenever I'm coaching, at some point, some issue of conflict will arise. It could be a small misunderstanding, a small assumption that builds and builds and builds, like a rolling stone gathering moss, as we say. Actually, I think it depends on how you perceive the word conflict. Conflict sounds like a very big, scary word, like a big argument, a big fight, and that is the Latin definition of the word. I prefer to use the word communications, choices, compromise. Now, compromise sometimes means giving something up, but actually, when you resolve conflict, what I found, it is very, very healthy because it allows you to understand the other person, your team members. It allows for innovation. And certainly, what I've seen is that when conflict is resolved, it's empowered teams. Now, sometimes there are conflicts where I've had it in my career where somebody has had to leave the business because they have made a choice that they do not want to stay, but were scared to say it or the culture didn't suit them. But actually, that's healthy for everyone anyway, because you want a team that's engaged and motivated. But if you can find a way of discussing things in an adult fashion, coming to a win-win situation, coming to choices that suit both parties, then it strengthens relationships. It actually uncovers innovation because you may well be resisting an idea that would benefit the team, but that person hasn't had the opportunity to speak up. It allows for continuous feedback. It allows you to see how your team members deal with conflict, how they interact under pressure. So it builds that understanding. And in today's world, where for many of us, we're working across teams and departments and we need to pivot quickly and be agile, it's absolutely critical we master these skills.